So I'm going to make off my first socket outlet here. Okay, it's a Crabtree branded one. And we can look in the back of it. We've got two earthing terminals here with the symbol for earth. So we've got CPCs to be connected in these two. And when there's two terminals, I like to put one CPC connection in each of those two terminals. Then we've got line and we've got neutral. Okay, we're going to double those terminations over and we're going to work out how deep the doubling over needs to be in order to get them in and we don't see any copper. Let's dress our cables to the right length or cut them to the right length. So if they're coming in from the sides as they are here, I like them to go past the box for my students between 50 and 70 mil. So we've gone 50 to 70 mil past in the direction. So we've gone past it. The same this side, 50 to 70 mil this way. So our cables are longer than the box in the opposite direction they came in. So coming from this side, and they're at least 50 to 70 mil longer than this way. Coming from this side, at least 50 to 70 mil longer this way. Let's work out how deep these terminals are. You're gonna need your electrician screwdriver when doing socket outlets, and not the wonderful terminal screwdriver that can go back in the toolbox for lighting circuits only. So if I open up my line connection, and then if I drop in a conductor I've got kicking around here, let's perhaps drop this one in here. Okay, I can start working out. It's not very deep, that one isn't, okay, at all. Okay, so when doubling that over, if I want to have a little practice go, I can work out how deep to go with that. So let's take this, shorten it down again. So students to practice beforehand with a scrap piece of conductor in order to work out how far to double it over. Even that's a little bit touch and go, even at that length. So I'll trim it back again. Trim back again, and then I'll use my doubling over technique. Slightly less than half. Fold it against the pliers and then crush it up like so. Let's see the depth now. Okay, so that's not really deep at all. Some are considered to be deeper than that that will work this. So students, remember, have a little practice first, get used to how far we're going in. The line connection neutral will be the same. Often the CPC has a different depth, so we'll have to practice again when we get there. So that's my practice attempt. Just leave it there so I can see it. So let's start off with the line. I know, again, some people remove the insulation around the brown line conductor using other kit, but I'm going to use my knife as usual. So take that one, press nice and firmly, pop that one off. If I bring the other one back, I can work the lengths out to be the same, like so. And then round again and pop that off. Remembering the insulation material around here is thermoplastic PVC. A maximum operating temperature of 70 degrees C. So we're ready to double these over, exactly the same as before, slightly less than half. Fold them against my pliers and then close up the gap like so. Take the second one and exactly the same as I just did. We can do the neutrals afterwards. Okay, like so. So I've got used to that. So I take my line conductors, I can pop those into the appropriate place, do a visual polarity check. That says L there, so I'm going to pop my two line conductors into here. Now, are they going to go flat or side by side? I'm going to do flat, so in other words, one top, one bottom as we go in, like so. Push them all the way in. Can't see any copper. Get my electrician screwdriver and obviously tighten those terminations up. Sometimes easier when you haven't got a tripod in the way. So tighten those up. Nice and tight, okay, into position. And then we can repeat the same process, obviously, for our neutral terminations, which is down here. So be careful, our neutrals are down here. Got to get an angled screwdriver in on this style. So let's back that screw back. Bit tricky to get it in. But it'll be tricky for me, it'll be tricky for my students. So back the screw back. We can do exactly the same with the neutrals. Double over my terminations. Just trim that a fraction. So that's my two neutrals done. And what I'm going to do is when I put them in, I'm going to have them sitting one on top of the other, like so. So I didn't go side by side. I sat one on top of the other when I put them into the terminations. Let's pop our neutrals in. So drop one in. Drop my second neutral in. I've got them one on top of the other, so I need to feed them in at the same time, like so. Always more difficult with a tripod in the way, guys. So let's see. I've got enough. Oh, hang on, didn't quite back the screw back enough. Okay, that'll make it a little easier. And we pop those two in front to back. So one on top of the other. Terminate those up, so tighten those off. Like so. Make sure they don't come out. I'll push them back in there. Difficult now to see on the camera, I know, but I'm pushing them down as I'm tightening them off. And those two are in position. And you can already see that we've got a reasonable length on those conductors, okay, which is what I like. I like them to spread out within the box. If they're a fraction long, we can always trim them back. If they're too short, replace the cables. On to the CPCs. Okay, so let's have a look at those. Let's have a look at the depth of the CPC terminals first. So we're going to use both of them. So there's one either side. Let's see how deep they are. So back the screw back. And let's just drop a little bit of conductor in there just to have a look. Oh, not very deep at all. They're hardly going at all. So they're going to be a lot smaller to get into there, making sure we screw into the copper and not the PVC. So let's measure these off to the appropriate length. I'm going to use them one against the other as a guide. So that's my CPC outer sheathing to identify the conductor. The line and neutral are 2.5. In this cable, the CPC is 1.5. Remembering CPC stands for circuit protective conductor, like so. And we're going to double those off. So I'm just going to have a look now. How far are we going to the hole? So it's probably going to be about perfect, that one. Double that one over, like so. Doubled over my CPC. And drop that into one of the two CPC terminations. If your socket only has one, obviously you're going to have to put the two in together. But where there is two, Gary likes you to use one in each of the terminating points. And we'll talk about that in the classroom for best practice moving forward. So tighten that one off. And we'll have a look here. I'm just going to fractionally, I've just got a little bit, a tiny bit off that one. Okay, CPC. Double over my CPC. Go into the second of the holes. Going to have to back this one back. Some sockets already haven't backed off, some don't. Push that through there. Hold it into position. Tighten it off so it doesn't pull back out. Tighten that down. Okay, so you can see my conductors are of a reasonable length. When they're that fraction longer, they are easier to get into a box than being too short. It isn't the other way around. Short is good. Short isn't good. Fraction long. And if they are too long, doesn't matter. We're practicing. We would trim them back. But let's see. So we're going to position them down into the socket itself. So making sure that we pull the cables down into positions so they can easily go back into the outlet itself. So I've dressed those into the back of the actual socket outlet. And that went down with ease. Okay, it comes up, down with ease. Important next trick. Lean it back, tighten them back off again. Give all the terminations a little nip up. Now you've moved them around and wiggled them. It's worth getting back in with your screwdriver and just checking that they haven't settled in and got a little bit looser. So we've done the top ones and then that little tricky neutral down there. Okay, so I've tweaked them up. Got to all that on site. Best practice, push it down into position, pull it back, recheck your terminations are tight and that can go down. See, the length easily goes down into the box. Too short is too difficult. The correct length will go back in a box if you spread the cables out accordingly.